Hello, this video gives you the solution to question bank on English poetry section. In question bank, there are total 6 extracts. Out of the 6 extracts, this video gives you solution to first, second and third extract. And check the next video for solution of extracts 4th, 5th and 6th. So just 2 videos for whole poetry section. In question paper, poetry is section 2, question 3. Part A is for 10 marks and Part B, appreciation, is for 4 marks. Let's see extract 1 of question bank. This extract is given from Song of the Open Road by the poet Walt Whitman. Let's see the questions under this. Pick out the 2 lines which describe the phrase good fortune. So the lines are, healthy, free, the world before me. Strong and content, I travel the open road. A2. Still here, I carry my old delicious burdens. Give reason for this statement. So as per the poet, the stress of life journey is called burden by the poet and he is happy to carry it. The poet carries sweet memories of people along with the path of life that satisfies him, hence calls it delicious. A3. Name and explain figure of speech used in the following line. The long brown path before me leading wherever I choose. So here, the figure of speech could be inversion, and the explanation to this is because the words are not arranged in proper order. Another figure of speech can be figure of speech alliteration. The explanation to this is sound of the letter L is repeated through words long and leading. We'll see A4. Express your own views regarding the following line. Song of the Open Road. This is personal response question. Song of the Open Road. From my point of view, this line urges us to be free from our routine life. One should take this open road to spot on the different opportunities that our life gives us. We should not limit ourselves with the boundaries of life. I think we should live a free life, living behind the worries and problems. A5. Compose 4 lines on journey of life by using the rhyming words. So we'll give the title Journey of Life and then compose those 4 lines. It is a path so difficult and tiring. It takes daunting labor, thus scaring. Eyeing the dreams to become someone, finally it builds me to a robust person. And part B, that is appreciation, is from the poem Money. This is written by William Davis. So let's see. Part B, appreciation. The poem Money is written by William Davis. It reflects poet status as both poor and rich man. The poet is inversely connecting money with happiness. The poem is simple and has narrative style. The rhyming scheme used in 5 stanzas is AABA, CADA, EFGF, HIJI, AKAK. The figure of speech used by poet are repetition, metaphor, exclamation, onomatopoeia, and inversion. The message that poet shares is that money is not required to be happy. In fact, money brings along fake people in one's life. In my opinion, happiness lies with genuine people. Though few, they must be true. So we now move on to extract 2 of question bank. The extract is on Indian viewers by Sarojini Naidu. Let's see the questions. A1. Fill in the columns based on your understanding of the poem. So the table that we can fill up is time of the day, early in the morning, late in the evening, in the dead night. Type of garment, robes for a newborn child, marriage veils of queen, dead man's funeral shroud. Color of garment, blue, purple and green and white. For whom? This would be for newborn child, queen and dead man. Moving to A2, complete the following web about what viewers compare the garments being woven by them. One is given to you, we have to fill up the 2. Robes of newborn child with blue wings of the wild halcyon. Next could be funeral shroud for the dead man like a feather and cloud. A3. Describe in your own words the steps or measures that you will take to solve the problems of the viewers. This is personal response question and the answer could be, at larger levels, these weavers should get some subsidy or discounts on yarn. also subsidy on loan for equipments needed. At an individual level, we can support weavers by buying products from them. Handmade products can be given more value than factory-made products. A4. The rhyming scheme in the first stanza is AABB. Find rhyme schemes in the second and third stanzas and also write down rhyming pairs of words of the second and third stanza from the given extract. So the rhyming scheme of second stanza is CCDD, third stanza EEFF, and the rhyming pairs of words are second stanza night, bright, green, queen. For third stanza, still, chill, shroud, cloud. Moving to A5, compose four lines on importance of clothes. The shirt that I wear is made of cotton and the thread that rolls through its button. Necessary are clothes I used to think to witness gladly draped saris of silk. Part B is appreciation of the poem Song of the Open Road by Walt Whitman. Let's see the appreciation. Song of the Open Road is a travel poem written by Walt Whitman. This poem is on the urge of freedom from our routine life. One should take this road to spot on the opportunities that a person wants. This poem is written in free verse. The poem has used repetition, metaphor, alliteration, paradox, and inversion. He used metaphor to road, which actually means the way of life. The poet used words like afoot, strong, content, healthy, free to describe the adventures of life. The message that poet shares is that we should not limit ourselves with the boundaries of life. In my opinion, we should live a free life, leaving behind the worries and problems. So, extract 3 from question bank is the Inchcape Rock. First question A1. Complete the web. We have to write the merits of Abbot of Aberbrothock. So the solution could be, it warns of dangers, sends signals to mariners and to give directions. A2. Give reason. The Abbot of Aberbrothock placed a bell on the Inchcape Rock because during the tide the rock remains submerged and he wanted the ships to be safer. Another reason could be, he wanted to save the mariners from ship collisions breaking as the Inchcape bell gave them signals. A3. If you were abbot of that era, what would you do to make the ship safe from crashing at Inchcape Rock? This is a personal response question, so the answer could be, if I were abbot of that era to save the ship from crashing at the Inchcape Rock, I would have installed magnetic device that could give signal about the Inchcape Rock to the captain of the ship. Next answer could be, I would have installed manual light reflectors so mariners would avoid the Inchcape Rock. A4. Complete the table. So the first example could be, the ship was as still as she could. Here, the figure of speech is personification and the explanation is, the ship is given human value. Next line, no stir in the air, no stir in the sea. Here, figure of speech used is repetition and the explanation is, the repetition of words no stir is there. A5. Compose a short poem. We need to write the middle two lines. So we can start with, no stir in the air, no stir in the sea, of the quiet and serene shore to sea. The breeze, the waves and the sun, her keel was steady in the ocean. Moving to appreciation, part B, this poem is Father Returning Home. So let's see the appreciation. Father Returning Home is a poem written by Dilip Chitre. This poem is a sketch of the poet's father. The poet shows the routine, tedious life that a person goes through. A person remains disconnected from family and the world outside. This poem is written in free verse. The poet has used repetition, metaphor, alliteration, paradox, personification, and inversion. The message that poet shares is of isolation of a person from the world. In my opinion, this simple written poem is relevant even today. Many of us may see themselves sharing similar conditions in life. So here we complete extract 1st, 2nd and 3rd of question bank. Do also check our another video on extracts 4th, 5th and 6th of poetry section. Please do subscribe for this revision series and like, subscribe and share our video.